Thank you. This one, $30.
Thank you. was supposed to take 3 weeks. This is how it takes 11 months. Right around the corner there from the new Old South Church, this beautiful old church, is the Boston Marathon finish line. So, you know, this is the Boston Marathon finish line. I would recommend you come down here. This is a really cool area to come down, hang around, walk around, get a little bite to eat, do some shopping on Newbury Street, you know. Everything around here in the older buildings, at least, is built on wooden pilings. Because this is landfill, they had to just put thousands and thousands of wooden pilings. So this church is actually sitting on 4,502 wooden pilings. This is the original MIT location. Ahead of us, right over here, is MIT original location. Now, I mean the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, not the Massachusetts Institute of Theater, which is a different MIT. And this is where it originally was. But then George Eastman of Eastman Kodak gave them a bunch of money. That's when they went out there to Cambridge and expanded the land area. So, see, now the original MIT location is at H&M, which is fine. You know, I'm not impugning the work of H&M. They do a really nice cut of the clothing. The thread count is one, but the cut of the clothing is nice. You know, if you want a large, you get a 7XL, you wash it in on. That's how you get a large. You have to know how to buy, you know. I got a Sabbath shirt. I got like Children of the Grave, you know that song on off of Essence. Anyway, I got the awesome shirt. I wore it home and I was like, hey, check it out. Check out my new Black Sabbath shirt. And my wife took it and she put it in the thing and dried it. And it was like this big. It came out of the dryer like this big. I was like, oh my God, I put it on that dog. We have a, well, it's almost like a dog. It's a pug. Look at this. This is the original location of MIT. And this is the original location of the Museum of Natural History. See on the left-hand side, see? That was the Museum of Natural History. Currently, it's the Restoration Hardware flagship store, so it's a great place to get a $300 hammer with a compass and a handle, Bluetooth optional. Maybe it turns into a flask, you know, I don't know. And they see what you're looking at there? I'll tell you what it is, the world's easiest hedge maze, you see? This is a big problem with the new generation. You see what I'm saying? Looking good. Let's do this. We're gonna pull up the lever, which engages the propeller. Here we go. Woo! Yeah! Put your hands in the air. Go woo! Woo! Wow, wow! The truck is now a duck and we are floating in the Charles River. Man, you put your hands up way late, kid. You're like, you were up the wind. He goes like this. Oh, yeah. You're going to be terrible at the wave. If you're going to be doing the wave, you're going to have to be a lot faster than that. Let's practice, okay? You ready? Go. Yeah, that was good. Yeah, you guys are good. All right, this worked out nice. Wow. Yeah. I'm gonna do this five times a day. Look at that pretty little building over there. Isn't this nice? You know, not every piece of architecture has to pop, you know. Sometimes a building's just unobtrusive, you know. If you go inside there, it's a little different than it looks on the outside, that building on the left. It's got this beautiful atrium lobby with the flowering magnolia tree. Nice woman in the welcome center. Her name is Mark. People think that the color of the water, it must have something to do with pollution. You know, it's a reasonable assumption to make. But it doesn't. It's from tannins, from tannic acid, from tree leaves. It's a pretty long river, 90 miles. The Charles River is 9 miles long. Kind of meanders around. It's pretty shallow. Once you get outside of the urban area, it's all overhang with tree leaves. They fall into the water. They biodegrade. They make the water this color. Now, was the river polluted once upon a time? Yeah, we got some locals. They know. If you listen, if it was 1970 and you were over here fishing by the banks of the Charles River looking for some of those famous three-eyed fish and you fell into the water, you'd come out of this water with 12 toes and the ability to see into the future. Okay, that's how polluted it was. Okay. Then you've got the Prudential Center over here. Then you've got the John Hancock Tower. See that mirrored building, the hat shell, the church steeple? That's all landfill. So we created all of that. Now you have an idea of the scale of the landfill project here in Back Bay. Do you have a rag over there, Jack? Let me see. Go ahead, you drive. I get this. How's those windshield wipers working, huh? Yeah, not great. $450,000 vehicle, they spent $1.97 on the windshield wiper. You know what I mean? That's fine. Yeah, that's fine. It should be fun. You want to take a break? Come on, come take a break. Jacqueline is union. She has to take a break. She's amphibious warship captain's local 375. Brockton. I'm also union, but SAG-AFTRA, so ask me how that's going. I'm going to be doing a lot more duck tours, I can tell you that. Okay, come on, come have a seat. Who wants to drive the amphibious warship? Let's start with this kid and then the kid back there. Come on up here, man. You're going to be driving, Maine. Okay? Now, let me see a camera, and I shall take a picture. Okay? Grab the wheel, though, kid. 10 and 2. Okay, you are actually driving. This is not like Pirates of the Caribbean. You are driving right now. Okay? Just take a beeline for that little dome there. Yeah. Don't get too close to the rocks. It's a lot of paperwork. This kid's not listening. You're getting a text. You mind if I take it? I'm just going to take it. Is that okay? I'm just going to say, don't tell me how to ruin my life. Okay, tell me your name, buddy.
Harris.
Say it again.
Harris.
Harris. Okay, Harris, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Harris, you can look back here for one moment. Harris, look over here. Harris, what are you looking at me for? You're supposed to be driving. Harris, good job, buddy. Well done. Thank you. Collect your round of applause. Harris, this kid.
Could I have you guys all to have a dice?
Technically, yeah.